Hello guys, good morning. So, new day, new episode. I didn't play it, I think last 2 days, so I think everything is a setup. Maybe Areza needs to play more. Cuenca is out, so I need to play with forward back. We are playing against Barcelona. So let's go. Let's destroy them. Definitely, I'm not afraid of them. Last night I was watching a little bit Real Madrid, Sevilla. I still cannot believe how Real is bad currently. I mean, just look at their bench. There is not any good player on the bench. I mean, Hazard is there, completely unfit. But look at other names. I mean, forget about Galacticos. Now they are just average. I mean, I would say not average, but slightly above average team. When you compare it with another one. I mean, I feel that quality in the football is just dropping. So these top teams are, they drop their quality, and that's why happen a lot of, like, fucking they're losing a lot of points. Of course, we must understand there is a lot of games in calendar what is really bullshit. I mean, Modric cannot play every third day. And he's now playing all the time. So imagine that one in one Real Madrid, he needs to play every game. So Real have some chances to win the match here. 1-2, I have 3 cards and lead. So, what to do? I have a reverse system. We will go like 3, I will do some sacrifices. So, fuck, I don't have even left back. No, wait. I don't have here who can play. I'm nothing, one sub and let's hope they don't get red card. Wait a moment, I need to give them this easy of tackles. One. Normally this can help a lot, so. For now, even match by statistic, maybe even Barca a little bit better. Areza is missing chances, this is not good for me. I have still Silas on bench, so if he doesn't score now, Silas will come. His rating is actually good. So, let's keep the trust in him, with him. 7.2 rating, it's really good. The wing back done everything. Very good cross. He just need to put his feet and that's it. That must be goal. Before I started recording, I was just checking the Champions League competition, and there are some potential nice draws for me. I will show you after this match. For example, you will see after the game. Come on now, counter. Come on, keep the clean sheet. Regarding the Real Madrid, if you watch Real Madrid-Chelsea game, I mean, you can see in that game how fitness, pace and youth is on Chelsea's side. That was insane. I mean, if you just observe the game, I feel Real, they just cannot play every third day. No chance. I still feel if they have the games one per week, they will still be very good, but in this stupid calendar, no chance. They are just too old. People often for asking me why Croatia was good in Russia. One of the reasons was that FIFA was increased the days between the games. I think it was 4 or 5. So this helped a lot to Croatia because we have a lot of older players. all these small things benefits. One day extra if you're playing is it's very big deal, trust me, especially if you are moving from other city to city. It's so fucking tiring. So here, if you go to competition, look, for example, Betis has lead against Juventus in a way. What else? Who was Porto defeated Real Madrid? So Porto will be nice draw. Lazio maybe also. So, but in the meantime, we need to perform against Borussia Dortmund in a way. So, as you can see, City is out of competition, PSG is also out from competition, so Liverpool, I would like to avoid just two English teams, United and Liverpool. If I can avoid them, I will have good chances to go to finale, that's the thing. But before Borussia game, I need to play one more in domestic league. We need to play against Betis at home. Did I lose first game against Betis? How is situations? Okay, a lot of players are returning. First of all, I will rotate my white players. That's the first thing. I will also rotate Tonali. I'm not big fan of Vasquez is out, so Meyer will play here, Palaverza will play here. I will play against Borussia 3-6-1 with Campbell up front. That's the plan. I will try to score one away goal and not concede more than 3. I mean, 2 is maximum. So, hoping to lose, let's say 2-1. Perfect for me. Because we won the first match 1-0. Regarding this domestic league, I mean, if you win here, I mean, most probably I will win this league. Only if I lose 10 games in a row. But 1-1 here, Fekir is playing. I need to take the 3 points here in this home game. As you can see, Sevilla, who was trailing me, now it's just dropping down. I will change the tactic and we will go with 2 CMs on attack. Maybe that's not wise, they have Fekir and C, so let me try to change something like this. So, who will I replace? Tonali will come in. And Silas also will come in. So let's start with one CM on defense, just because they have Fekir who is playing behind the striker. If I cannot score, then I will change to 2 CMs on attack, but we scored, Silas scored. Another very important interception by my midfielder. Immediate quick transition, but Silas missed the chance. Let's go a little bit calm down. Come on, Meyer, I need to see. I mean, definitely for attacking midfielder, I need to see more goals from set pieces. That's why. I mean, Bruno Fernandes will be fantastic, I think, for me. But I will never have money to buy this kind of players. I need always, you know, to buy cheap. Cheap, but good. Okay, here is the game over. I mean, now we destroyed them. So, you saw what I done. I changed the tactic because I was not happy. So I decided to go with 1 CM on defense just because Fekir is playing behind striker. To have some guy who is, let's say, staying deeper. Of course, if the result was draw, then last 20 minutes I will change to both of them to attack. Ice hockey match. So we rest both of the wide players. Oh, I have Borussia Dortmund away, Sevilla away, Atletico Madrid away. I feel all three I will play. Maybe Sevilla will play with two strikers, but three at back. I have tough run, so three at back. So we will go 3-6-1 as I promised. Busquets will go here. Ahmed Hodžić Libero, Sanz here. Tonali. Meyer. Vasquez. Campbell will lead the line. He will go left. You will go right. Christensen is suspended. The goalkeeper can stay on the bench. So Palaversa need to play in the mid. I'm short of the midfielders, but at least I can start like this if needed. Then I will lose one midfielder. I will go with two strikers. So let's hope I can counter this stupid Borussia Dortmund. I mean, they will score at least one against me, so I need one goal to score. So we are parking the bus. I mean, as I mentioned before, this tactic on the paper looks, when you look at formation, it looks defensive, but it's not defensive, trust me. Because we are still using attacking midfielder, we have two. I mean, we have good options in transition phase. Just I have Aguilar with the card. So you see, they have zero shots on the target. I have one. I need to replace him. And I need to pray that Tonali doesn't get. Come on now. Of course, I have Andrada on the goal. Plenty cards. Plenty cards. What I'm sure, I will replace him. Easy of tackles. No, I will continue like this. I have still a good result for me. Come on, defend. Where is the Silas? Campbell didn't do nothing, no any chances, so Silas I'm putting. Silas going because he has more pace than Areza. Come on, deep. Oh, all three are having the card. Come on, Silas, you are playing because of pace. Calm down. Come on, Silas, run! Run, Forest! Do not lose the ball. I have still one sub, so actually I will leave the time, I will just put Areza. I don't have midfielders. I can maybe change the left back, but no. I don't want to do it. They just don't have high quality. If you're asking me what tactic I will use if I have top team, definitely this 3-6-1. Because like this I will be defensively the strongest and I will always score at least one goal too. If you have top striker, play this system, trust me. 3-6-1, if you have a like striker, high quality. For example, you play Newcastle, I will play 3-6-1. You have Callum Wilson. And I mean he can score by goals by himself. So again, you saw everything very defensively good. So this is my recipe how I'm planning to play in the Champions League. Win at home. So Lazio, Barcelona. Come on, I will be happy with Betis or Porto. When is the draw? 9-0. So I need to avoid United or Liverpool. Champions Cup draw 18. And the semi-finals, come on, be a draw. Please, it will be best if Liverpool and United are on different part of draw. Oh, FC Porto, excellent. Come on, Bayern Lazio, United, please Liverpool. Yes, Milan, Juventus. Juventus lost first game 2-1, then qualified. And how is the draw for semi-final? Bayern or Lazio. I mean, so let's hear it. We have Sevilla away. I will play 3 at back, but with 2 strikers. I mean, I will not have enough midfielders to play with. The version with 1 on defend. So, who will play up front? Campbell Arezzo. I need to force Arezzo. Meyer will play, I'm safe. Where is... We will go like this. Palaversa, bench. Bench, bench, bench. Bench. Again, I conceded early goal. I mean, this Tonali is brain. I'll describe him like that, brain. Just having the cards over replace him. I don't play in good, I will need to change the system. You see the stats? Very, very poor playing by me. I will change to my 4. 4-4-2. Not happy at all. Easy of tackles. So all 3 subs are done. I'm losing against this shitty Sevilla. At least I would like to see point, just not to lose the match. But you see, they are this is fucking derby, they are... Yeah, I need to draw at least here. Because I have now, again, I am playing against Atletico Madrid away. Okay. Come on now, come on! Barcelona is having 1 game less. So this is, as I said, you cannot play with only one tactic. If you want to have maximum results, a small team, big team doesn't matter. So you see, I was not happy with statistics, didn't create a lot. I changed the tactic. And as I said, biggest advantage of my tactic is that all of them require same type of player. Only the Targetman version, they require Targetman, but it's not, doesn't need to be classic Targetman, just the guy who has some strength including and jumping. Nothing special. We will see how will I do with Huesca. If I can win the Champions League this season, most probably I will stop playing with them. And then I'm also planning to do one fast run of Millwall with Targetman approach. I mean, Championship is always, you buy 1-2 player, you can loan, I think, 4, and that's it. I didn't check, is there any good one on the free transfer, that's also a valid option. So that's the plan for every Championship side. And of course, if you're picking the team, pick the team who fits in the tactic. More players you have who fit in the tactic and formation, much easier. I mean, Millwall doesn't exactly fits, but it's my favorite team from the Championship. We won here, you saw. Changed formation, we won. The positive factor is now we have 7-8 days until next game, because we don't play the Spanish Cup and all other bullshit things. How will I play against Atletico Madrid? Is 9 on the table. Will I play 3-6-1 for fun? Or I would rather go my standard 4-4-2. And just try to outscore them. And after that I have also Gijón away. I mean, I guess Gijón I will go with 2 strikers, doesn't matter, but... Everybody is ready. I mean, last match I started like this, it was not so good. Let's play 3-6-1. Defensive football. Actually, Vasquez can play, so that means Meyer can play one of the midfielders. Okay. I mean, I hope I will not concede early goal. What are the teams recommended from the Championship? It depends what you want to play. For example, I recommend Stoke, because you have Campbell as striker, you have that one guy, Collins, or what's his name, as central defender, high potential. You have left-footed striker, what is very rare. So, I done already one run on the Stoke on the Twitch, and we won the title easily. So... just buy Ricky J. Jones and pair him with Campbell up front. You will have 2 British strikers. And then you just buy him. Maybe one more guy, depends who you can get. Stoke is not having money so much. And just loan 4 players. That's it. I think I just bought one guy and the rest was loan. And I still won easily. And you play these tactics. That's it. If you want target man approach, there are teams like Beningen, who has, I think, that Cosgrove and few others. Then there is Millwall, what I want to try to with Zohore up front as target man, because he has decent mobility. Then you have, who else you have, Beningen have. There is Cardiff with that Kiefer, what his name it is. So there are a few options for target man approach. The problem is all these teams, they don't have their, I mean, you will need to spend a lot of money to buy strikers in the future. That's why Stoke has Campbell. You buy Jones cheaply and just use him 1 year in championship. His attributes will grow insanely. And that's it. So here, again, we are showing defensive strength, no yellow cards. Campbell score goals, so we continue playing like this. This is the bad. I was hoping for offside, but no luck. They are playing standard classic 4-4-2. Against... actually, I will change and I will go with two strikers now. I have some cards, so... Will I go 4-4-2? No, 3 at back I'll keep. Tonali will go here. Busquets. Busquets will go here. Up front. Arezzo or Silas. Morale is perfect. So Arezzo will go. I clicked the wrong one, entire team. Come on, Campbell. Regarding the French team, France, I mean, there are interesting teams. I would like to play probably with Lens. Then Montpellier is also a good choice. Then maybe, I think, for target men, Strasbourg is having one good one. Angers is also a good team to play my tactic. Let me do just one sub to leash the time. Calm down. Come on, Arezzo. Boom! Counter attack! So, I can be stronger defensively than Atletico Madrid. Don't worry, I have tactics for everything. I think we have time to play one more. I didn't expect that I will win all the time. You see, I'm winning even away games. No, we will play my 4-4-2. Let me do quick pick to B. Maybe I needed to rest the wing backs shit because I need to play, I think, Champions League after this. I will replace both of them at halftime. Yeah, in this episode we played a lot of hard away games, so I mean you saw everything. Can I score? No early goal. Okay, I was wrong. So what we said, I need to replace both of them. And actually I will replace Tonali, so 3 subs instantly. I need Tonali, Ahmed Hodžić to stay injury free. I mean, I have 3 decent strikers, so let's say Campbell stays also injury free. So Arezzo or Silas, it's enough one of them. If somebody needs to injure one of them, can be. I mean, Vasquez, veteran player, but still, even season 2 is performing good for me. I mean, if I have a lot of money in the next season, I would like to buy world-class attacking midfielder and world-class central defender. And that's it. I mean, this Ahmed Hodžić is on loan, if I'm correct. Maybe to try to buy him. But one top attacking midfielder, I mean, I like Meyer, but he is not the world-class. I need world-class player on that position. Maybe, for example, I don't know how hard stats, I don't know, Reina from Borussia Dortmund, something, some kind of wunderkind. But a wunderkind who is already proven player, who has high attributes, not like wunderkind who needs 2 years to develop. I need somebody instant, but world-class. And Reina is actually playing. This is now already season 2. He's playing, so. I mean, even if I win title here, I will not give. They will not give me plenty money. Maybe only Champions League can save me. Oh! So I lost him. So top 4 secure. So guys, I mean, you saw everything. We are now playing against Porto, and after that probably will be Bayern. So I think we can reach the final. I mean, against Bayern will be tricky, but I would rather play against Bayern than against Liverpool or United. And Liverpool and United playing between themselves. So some injuries are fucking me. I lost one central defender. So this will be end of this episode. See you probably this afternoon. I will try to record one more. Okay, good luck, bye.